Croeso, welcome to the third in our Lent series of videos. We're delighted to welcome Mary Stallard, the Archdeacon of Bangor, as she reflects on Lent as a season of learning, gently.
We're quite a few days into Lent now. Lent, that season for Christians to think about learning. And this has been really natural. Christians have talked for years about a Lenten discipline, about having it as a time of restraint, a season to concentrate on self-discipline. But this year, there's been a real focus amongst Christians upon learning something gentler, upon responding to this time of pandemic and noticing the need that so many people have when they're stressed and tired to learn a bit more about God's gentleness, God's tenderness, God's desire for us to flourish. And we hear about that in the story that I've chosen from the first book of Kings, a story about the prophet Elijah, who is such a great example of humanity.
Today's reading comes from 1 Kings chapter 19, verses 1 to 9. Elijah flees from Jezebel. Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done and how he had killed all the prophets with the sword. Then Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah, saying, "So may the gods do to me and more also, if I do not make your life like the life of one of them by this time tomorrow." Then Elijah was afraid. He got up and fled for his life, and came to Beersheba, which belongs to Judah. He left his servant there. But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness, and came and sat down under a solitary broom tree. He asked that he might die. "It is enough now, O Lord, take away my life, for I am no better than my ancestors." Then he lay down under the broom tree and fell asleep. Suddenly, an angel touched him and said to him, "Get up and eat." He looked, and there at his head was a cake baked on hot stones and a jar of water. He ate and drank and lay down again. The angel of the Lord came a second time, touched him and said, "Get up and eat, otherwise the journey will be too much for you." He got up and ate and drank. Then he went in the strength of that food for 40 days and 40 nights to Horeb, the Mount of God. At that place he came to a cave and spent the night there. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Elijah is sent by God to give God's message to people who don't want to hear. And the first part of the story before the bit I've chosen for today tells of how Elijah has terrible clashes with King Ahab and Queen Jezebel. And the difficult thing for Elijah is every time he tries to do God's work, things just get worse. And so Elijah flings himself to the ground and says, "I've had enough. God, I'm giving up." He shows us something of what we all know when life is hard and when we're tempted just to want to drop out of everything. Maybe he points to those moments that you might have experienced of feeling really deep despair. But the beautiful part of the story is God doesn't give up on Elijah. God comes to Elijah in the form of an angel who provides for him what he needs and tells him, "Get up and eat." Twice God feeds Elijah and tells him to go on a journey that will last 40 days. Doesn't that speak to us, to those of us who are exploring what 40 days of Lent might mean? Elijah, strengthened by food given by an angel, goes on a journey that will lead to more learning, where God will appear to him. And Elijah will find that God is quite different from anything and everything that he expects. This Lent, maybe there's an opportunity for us to reflect upon how God appears to us, how God encourages us, even when we're ready to give up. I wonder who has provided for you the things that you've needed when you've been tired, or when it's been difficult to find a way forwards. Who's encouraged you? Who's noticed you? And maybe also there's an opportunity to think, when might we be angels for others? When might we be the ones who provide for others so that they can continue, so that they can carry on their journey? Lent is a time for learning. So let's have eyes, ears and hearts open. Open to notice the God who only wants us to flourish. Let's notice the signs of grace and encouragement in our lives. And let's set ourselves to be those for others. God of the Lenten journey, thank you that you are always with us. Thank you that you never give up on us. Thank you for those who encourage, help, and point us towards your hope. Help us to be signs of hope, grace, and tenderness to others. Amen.